welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new here. I'm Sammy. Welcome to the Samily. Make sure you guys have subscribed down below if you haven't already and give this video a big thumbs up. So I asked you guys to ask me some juicy questions on Instagram and I haven't looked at any of them yet, so I'm a little nervous, but Claire's gonna be asking me them and I guess we'll just see how this goes.
Okay, so the first question is, do you like surprises? Why or why not?
I actually love surprises. No one ever really surprises me. Honestly, I can't really think of a time I've ever been surprised. But I do have a little story because I really always wanted to get surprised. And in eighth grade, a lot of people were having surprise birthday parties and I wanted one too. But you know, you don't really ask for a surprise birthday party because that's just not how it works. But of course, me being the little
extra bitch I am,
told my mom, I want a surprise party and you need to text my friends and plan a surprise party for me. So being the amazing mother that she is, she said, okay. I decided that I wanted to be difficult because I'm a
fucking difficult bitch.
When my friend texted me asking me to go to dinner, which I knew was obviously the surprise party, she was like, oh, we should go to To Kill a Mockingbird. And I was like, no, I don't really wanna go to Tequila. Like, let's go to like Spiga, or like I said a different restaurant name. And she was like, no, like, we should go to Tequila. And like me just knowing that we had to go to Tequila, I was like, well, like we should go to the diner, which is like right next door. Eventually, obviously I gave in because I wasn't just gonna like fight her. I think I acted really surprised. I had a really fun time. I don't think anyone ever knew that I was behind this surprise. So if you guys are watching this, surprise! And if you are the friend of mine that was inviting me to dinner,
I'm literally so sorry.
But I'm also not, so like,
What's your favorite memory from this year so far? Because it hasn't been the best one.
Yeah, it really hasn't been the best one.
I think Playlist was so fun. It was actually like the week before Corona really like
went off.
So it was kind of like the last thing that I really got to do before we quarantined.
What are some of your favorite TikToks right now?
I don't really know how to like describe TikToks. I don't really know how I'm like supposed to do that. So I'm just gonna like put them in. I like your sketch out, if you like me, my Gucci shoes. I'll buy you the best only if you show me your boobs. I like your sketch out, you like me too. Bring your friends all.
Alexa, I am Ariana Grande.
Yes, you are Ariana Grande. Anyone to say otherwise is an imbecile and shall be annihilated by end of the day. Rise, my queen. Rise.
Yo, Lizzo, I've been trying to write this sentence. I don't know how to end it.
So I got the quick brown fox jumped over the mushy human corpse.
But like, Lizzo, what punctuation do I use? Lizzo, stop playing your flute. I need some help. This is due like in 5 minutes.
Okay, I like hope you guys thought those were like funny. Please,
I'm gonna be doing this while you're talking. So what is something that we don't know about you?
Oh, secrets. Okay, so I feel like one thing that a lot of people don't know about me is sometimes when you meet me, I can actually be really like shy and kind of awkward at first. Even if it doesn't show, sometimes I can like come off really friendly and excited to meet you, but inside a lot of the time I'm freaking out. I'm like so nervous because I care way too much about what people think of me.
What's your craziest hookup story?
Oh god. Okay, so I never tell stories like this, so this is very interesting, but I'm gonna like get a little crazy with you guys today because I'm like fun and quirky or whatever. Like thinking about. Okay, so me and my best friend Lindsay went to the Bahamas together, just us two. I don't know why our parents even let us do that, but anyways, hi mom and dad, thank you so much for letting me do that. I really appreciate it, and I promise I was 99.9% of the time responsible. This is the 0.1% of the time that I wasn't responsible. Okay, so anyways, we went out to the club and the whole Penn State basketball team was there for a tournament and we met them at the club and we're hanging out with them. And when it was time for the club to close, we went back up to some of their hotel rooms and we were hanging out.
You're okay.
I really like these shoes.
You're okay.
Thank
They're so big.
One thing led to the next, and I ended up hooking up with one of the players, and so did Lindsay. We literally left Atlantis at like 5 a.m. and went back to our hotel. And we were both like, what the heck just happened? Also, this was our first night. Like, this was the first night we were there. Should I start over?
No, I think that was perfect.
Okay, that's that, yeah.
What makeup brand do you think is the most overrated?
I don't really do like a lot of makeup, and I don't really do a specific makeup routine. I was actually just in James Charles's recent video, you should go check that one out, but I was telling him how my makeup routine is literally so bad. I don't use beauty blenders, I don't bake, I don't contour, I don't really know what brands are overrated because I've never really gone out there and bought anything that I don't like because I literally use the same makeup that I've used since middle school. But I really like the James Charles palette.
Are you ever going to do another YouTube series?
Okay, this is something that a lot of people have asked. Honestly, I do not know. A lot of time and money went into it. We definitely would need some funding if we want to do another series, whether it be similar to Project Elimination or if it's something totally different. But if you guys do want to see another series, definitely let me know. And if you want to sponsor another series, let me know. Claire, what do you think about doing another series?
Honestly, I think we should.
Yeah, so we want to do it. We just need money. So, like, this is my Venmo is right here. I don't actually know my username, but I'll, like, put it in. Like, pay me.
Who is your celebrity crush?
Okay, I feel like my celebrity crush kind of changes a lot, and I have many of them. But right now, my main celebrity crush is Tony Lopez.
I'm a party girl. She just want to fun.
I think he's so hot. I have his helicopter merch.
We all know what's up with that.
Okay.
I'm like, helicopter.
What was your worst celebrity experience?
Honestly, I haven't had that many bad celebrity experiences. For the most part, so many people have been so nice. The one person that I definitely did not have a good experience with was Bradley Cooper. So my mom works for a charity called the Arthur Miller Foundation. So they had a really big fundraiser and Bradley Cooper was a part of it. And there was like a small after party just for the people that had put it together and the people that were involved. I really wanted a picture with him and I really liked him. I thought he was funny. And there were people taking pictures with him, not constantly, but people were going up to him and talking to him and stuff. Eventually, I did go up to him. So I just introduced myself, and before I could even like finish speaking, he just took my phone and took a selfie of us and just handed it back and walked away. And I was like, okay. What if I wasn't gonna ask for a picture? You know, what if I was gonna say, hi, my name's Sammy, like I really liked the performance you gave tonight or something like that. That's so awkward.
Next question. Who did you expect to win Project Elimination?
Honestly, going into it, I was thinking kind of either Logan or Rachel because they're both really determined people. I know that they're both really athletic and smart, and I could see them just being really competitive, but also, especially Rachel, getting along with everyone, forming a lot of alliances, you know, making it through, not getting voted into that many challenges.
Would you ever make an OnlyFans?
I honestly would literally never, like, you could not pay me to do that. I mean, no, that's the point of OnlyFans. I know a lot of people are making them right now because of quarantine. Everyone's bored, wants money. Like, Tana keeps teasing about making one. I could never, ever make one. No. Unless you want me to, like, post just extra, like, pictures of, like... Never mind. I was gonna say, like, my dog is, like, a joke, but I don't even have a dog, so, like, never mind.
Share your first kiss story.
Okay, this is another great story. Okay, so in 8th grade, I had a Valentine's Day party, which, you know, was a big deal because there was gonna be girls and boys there.
Ew.
So my friends and I decided that we wanted to play spin the bottle and suck and blow. We decided to, like, take garbage bags and cover all of the windows in, like, my playroom because that's where the party was gonna be, and we didn't want my parents being able to see what we were doing. So that was our solution. The one problem with our friend group at the time was there was probably 6 or 7 boys and like 25 girls. We made 2 circles, one for the guys and one for the girls, and one of the guys would like spin the bottle in their circle, then one of the girls would spin a bottle in their circle, and then, you know, the two people would kiss and it would be like, oh my god. So that's where I had my first kiss, and then also like my second and third and fourth and fifth kiss, because a lot of people kissed people there. At that time I was like,
what's it like editing for Lila and Amanda?
Oh my god, okay, honestly, editing for Lyle and Amanda is so much fun. It's kept me really busy during quarantine, and it's also let me be really creative, and it's just like so fun to like help them with videos and get everything out and see the final product. If anyone needs anything edited, DM me or email me and I can send you my rates.
What are your summer plans? Are you still moving to LA?
Today is May 5th. I don't know when I'm posting this, but today is May 5th. And I was supposed to move to LA on May 5th. But because Miss Rona came and, you know, wanted to
hang out for a while,
I am not moving to LA right now. But whenever this is over, first place I'm going, LA. For now, I'm staying in Connecticut, and I'm actually really excited because I am doing a remote summer internship with Dormify. You guys have seen me do videos with them before, so I'm really excited about that. I love them. I love everyone there. They're so nice, and all of their dorm decorations are so cool. If you guys need any dorm or room decorations, I'm gonna put a link down below where you guys can get 20% off. That went from like sad to like promo. Like, okay, like which is it? Honestly, everything happens for a reason. I know I'll eventually end up in LA, but I'm really excited to be doing this.
How did you end up so connected in the music industry?
So this is kind of a long story that's very random, but I'm gonna try to consolidate it a little bit. 3 years ago at Coachella, this guy ended up giving me and my friend Michaela artist passes. He was going back to LA because he only was going to Coachella for that Friday. LA things, like, relatable. And so he gave us his passes, and we didn't really know what we were going into. We didn't really know what artist meant, but he had told us, like,
oh yeah, like, go to this entrance.
It took us backstage, and it's a whole another world back there. It's literally crazy. There's golf carts that'll take you stage to stage. There's a little hangout area behind each stage, which you guys might have seen kind of in my videos. And it's like a lot of celebrities, obviously, but also just a lot of people that work in the music industry. I got to talk to a lot of cool people and kind of, you know, connect with them and network, which was really fun. Someone was like, oh, I'm like Usher's creative director. And I was like, so I then ended up getting artist passes for GovBall that year. And I ended up kind of getting really close to some of the people that work like in the industry and just are connected with it. And we kind of ended up just becoming really close and staying really close. You know, sometimes we're all going to an event and we'll all have artist passes or something of the sort. I'm really grateful, honestly, because it's shown me a whole different side of like the entertainment industry in general. I've actually learned a lot. One of like the reasons that I was really sad about Coachella being postponed was obviously the music, but also that's kind of the event that all of our friends go to. They're mostly adults. We all get to hang out. We all go to all the after parties together. And honestly, they feel like my second family.
So we love you all. Let's get fucked up. Have a good time.
Going to events and being able to see people in the artist compounds and recognizing people like, oh, hey, like you're so-and-so. Just having that connection is so nice because whenever I'm backstage, it kind of like feels like home in a way because I walk around and I recognize people and it's really nice. And it's also just really fun because the artists and all the celebrities that are, you know, that go are hanging out back there, but it's not so chaotic. It's really easy to just go up to someone and talk to them and have a conversation with them and then maybe at the end ask for a picture. I know I'm like going on a rant now, but I don't really care. Last year I saw Kendall Jenner like backstage after I think it was Jaden Smith's set at Coachella, and I went up to her and I was like, hey, I'm Sammy, like, and she's like, hey, I'm Kendall. And I was like, yeah, I know, I didn't say that, but I thought it was funny. And I was talking to her, I was like, oh yeah, it's like you're having fun. Just normal conversation, like literally she was so sweet. I was like, okay, well, like I'm gonna run to whatever set, but like, can we take a picture really quick? So nice. It's a really cool experience, and overall I'm like really grateful to get to go to all these cool events, and it's really shown me a different side of everything. I know that was like really chaotic and I just said a lot of things, and what was the how I got into it. Okay, but I answered that. How did I do?
Good.
You think that was okay?
No, I think that was good.
I think I got a little off track.
No, but it was like good stuff.
All right, you guys, so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up down below and subscribe and turn your notifications on. I am sorry that it took me so long to post, but between quarantine and final exams, it was just very chaotic. But I'm gonna be trying to post a lot more now that that is all over. If you guys wanna see anything specific, definitely comment down below. I have some really fun quarantine video kind of ideas. So I'm really excited to get back to posting. But that's all for today. So I will see you guys soon. Bye, love you.